You know, it was an honor for me to be a No Limit soldier. To be honest, all my career, it was an honor to be a hardhead with Roderick Smith.
Yep.
Rest in peace. It was an honor to be Rough Eric with Henry Glover and Ed and all of them and Legend Man and the rest of the crew. It was an honor to be there because those people believed in me. Those people put their money behind me and they put all they stuff on my shoulder and I never let none of them down. Everybody with Rough Eric never had no album sell over 20,000, 40,000, 50,000 copies until I came there. They had them put out my a guy that was like my brother. He was with Murder Inc. with me. He was with Hardhead with me. Legend Man. They put him out. He did real well. They put Face Forever out before Legend Man. They had put Sporty T out a Sporty T album. So at the end of the day, when I came there, it was just a different ball game. It was a different ball game. When I put my songs out, and I had featured on all of their albums, so those guys kind of helped me because I featured on their album, so the fans that they had, you know, became my fans too. Yeah, so they was always like, the streets had started asking for me because Henry, his fate was in Face Forever. Like, that was his group. Like, that was his, like, he had love for them dudes. Like, I think they was from the Night One, that's where he was from. So, the CEO of Rough Era, that was his favorites. But once they put their album out and everything, they had started asking for more money and stuff, you know, because they was ready to leave the label. So they started wanting to negotiate for more money. So he got mad and he was like, man, we just gonna go with this crazy thing. And we did it. When I did the Chopper song, I liked the Chopper song. And nobody ain't really believe in the Chopper song but me and Ed. Like, Henry didn't like the CEO from Rough Era, he didn't like the Chopper song. Crazy. We put it on the mix show. We put that thing on the radio. It was over.
It blew up.
It was over. The whole city.
I play that now still, like, you know, jamming the... Yeah.
But you know what I'm saying? When ahead, I first got my Chopper, I couldn't use it. Now they water thug hate me, so I abuse it. Hey, yo, dude, crazy, that's what... Roger told me, if you ever cross my family, your life is what you owe me. I'm the proud of you. I could go forever, man. You know, it's music. It was music, and Henry became a believer. He like, oh, man, that Chopper the day, man. That Chopper the day, man. That Chopper the one. He became a believer. Like, I made him a believer. He already believed in my talent, but he didn't really know. Like, I don't think he knew what he had. Like, and then everybody started coming. And then he realized it because, like I say, his favorite group was Face Forever and Legend Man. All them people was like people that knew him. He didn't really know me. I'm from the Iberville Project. You know, dudes from the Night Water, from the East. He didn't know me like that to believe in me. But he know they could rap. He been knowing them his whole life. But when I came in, it was like something different. Now, he wasn't affiliated with the Iberville or nothing. Now, he affiliated with the Iberville. So all of that stuff take time, you know. You have to learn each other, you know, and... See, Murder would come out every time. See, Murder was coming out. Like, and that was big for me because, you know, No Limit was big. I had already had my group over there. You know, like the Gambino fam. That was my group. I started the Gambino fam.
Well, I was going to ask you about this because, you know, we
spoke. Yeah, I'm getting ahead of you, man. I'm going to hold slow back and let you go. Go ahead. I'm going to let you do you. Go ahead.
I
you got to cut me off, man. You know, I'm a dude. I'm a
talker,
man. Cut me off.
Yeah, because some of the fans, they've definitely heard Breather Life being represented. And even just, you mentioned Breathers, like the Gambino family. We've heard them on a lot of stuff talk about being Breathers and stuff. Even Slay Sean, like Click Breathers and that. So can you break that down for us, the whole Breather Life movement and stuff like that?
The Breather Life is a big old movement. Like, most of the time you see the Breather Life is a whole nother record company. Like, Breather Life is the record company originated from the Night Walk. Breather Life is me. But these were people who was around me that just believed in me. Like, they believe in me so much, like, all of them call me King Breather. Like, King, you know, King Breather, and just, they just real loyal. They brothers now. They ain't just breeders, they my brothers, you know. They like people that, you know, I go to war with. But when we started the Breather thing, let me take you back. It was me, rest in peace, Mr. Sleep. And it was Tucci Man, who y'all know as Lil Gotti. I named Lil Gotti from the Gambino family Lil Gotti. I gave him that name. His real name was like Lil Wayne be calling himself. Lil Wayne took his name, his street name, Tucci. His real name was Tucci Man. That's Reginelli's big brother.
Big bro.
Lil Gotti is Reginelli's big brother. Reginelli was kind of a baby when me and he got together. I got the Breeder tattoo. Sleep got the Breeder tattoo. We all had the same tattoo artist. This tattoo that's on my arm right here.
Okay.
All of us had the same tattoo. Lil Gotti got it. Sleep got it. Sam got it on his stomach. My bro.
Is that Lil Sam from that would have?
No, not him. No, 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 no.
Oh, your
no
brother.
Way.
Oh, your brother Sam.
Okay. Yeah, not yeah, nah, yeah, not oh, him. Nah, you, nah, nah.
Your big brother Sam.
But anyway. I'm talking about Big Sam.
We could do this with the heads. Big Sam, you know, that Stroganoff took Sam down.
But Sam, I'm talking about the Sam who was literally like a mini Suge Knight.
say no more.
Everybody loves Sam. We talk about him. But I know him. No, we went to school together when we were small. That's Sam cool. But anyway, you know how it go when I know you're going to get to a lot of stuff, but you know how stuff go. Some of the people knew me my whole life. And when things go to getting hot in the streets, you know, this person, you know, people just trying to get on and just start having problems with people they knew their whole life. And I don't respect that, because that's like fine. And me and you don't talk for 20 years. I know we was real. You always was real with me. So that gonna still hold weight. Just because you ain't heard from me in 20 years don't mean you got no faker. Or I got no faker. That just mean we ain't catch up with each other. I'ma judge you off the time that we did have before we had the vacation from each other.
Yeah.
I'ma judge that. I'ma still remember that. We're gonna pick up where we left off 20 years ago. Man, let's go get us a drink, Fonz. Let's get you still rapping. Let's get in the studio. You know what I'm saying? That's just me.
Just like yesterday. Just like I seen you yesterday, that's how it would be. Facts.
Yeah, I'm like that. I come to UK. As soon as I get off the plane, even on my way there, I'm going to say, I got a brother out here. I got a breed out here, a soldier out here. Yeah. I'm going to know I already got family out there. You know, I got Fonz there. I got Fee Breeder. You know, I know who I got out there in certain places in any country. I know who I got in every country. You know, I got breeders in every country, and I know y'all mean a lot to me. So I know who it is over the years. I'm not a fake person. Like, at the end of the day, if I fuck with you, I mess with you. It's for life with me. Unless you do me something, unless you snake me in some kind of way to ruin a relationship. The relationship don't never change. Just because a person don't talk to me don't mean the relationship change. We just ain't talking. You either busy or I'm busy. But we ain't had no fallout. So long we had no fallout, we good. That's the type of person I am. Like, that's what I used to tell people. I tell people with P. With P, I'm a ride or die, because me and P don't get in no arguments like he might have with everybody else. It's not like that, because guess what? I recognize him as the colonel of the team, because he the boss. No Limit is Master P, bro. When I wear this tank right here, I ain't wearing this tank for no music. I wear this tank to represent my big brother. All the tanks I got, I wear them to represent P, because P enlisted me in that army, and that was a big time in my life. So that's why I don't wear this for no music. I wear this to represent the love I got for P, the loyalty I have for P. When I think of No Limit, I think of Master P. They had a lot of good rappers on No Limit, or some killers on No Limit, if you want to say Mystical or somebody like that. Killers that I think carried the label. But the one who started the label is P.
Yep.
Plain and simple, he the colonel. Everything came through him. Every decision came through him. Period. That's his company. That's his dream. Whether he want to call it No Limit Forever. Wait, No Limit, the new No Limit. Gutter Music, No Limit South, Soldier Army. Anything that's connected to that. When you think of No Limit, who the first name you think of? Be honest.
Pete,
when you say No Limit, you think of Pete.
Nobody else is.
Peace, family. Thanks for joining us. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe. And check us out on BoutTheOnline.com. Also, check us out on Facebook for exclusive listen new content. And don't forget, as I said, like, share, subscribe. Peace.